hellraising. Hellraising. I'm ready for the worst. So frightening. Face whitening. Feel that you can reverse. My phone has no signal, it's making my skin crawl. The silence is so loud. The lights spark and flicker with monsters much bigger than I can control now. Welcome to the panic room, where all your darkest fears are gonna come for you, come for you. Welcome to the panic room, you'll know I wasn't joking when you see them too, see them too. Welcome to the panic room.
Guys, smash up that like button. We're gonna get started soon. What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the stream. I hope everything is working. Just doing a screen cap video. Didn't have all that much time to set up. This kind of came as a surprise to me. We just like launched into a new all-time high on a Monday night here in the US. Let's see what happened over the past few hours. Let's go over to past hour. So it looks like, you know, just recently we went from 66.5 and now into a new all-time high. So congratulations, guys. We are now officially in new all-time highs for Bitcoin. And this is really perfect. Honestly, it's perfect. This is pretty much, you know, what we've all kind of been, or at least all the bulls have been expecting. And this is extremely classic behavior for Bitcoin also going into the end of the year. If you guys know, I mean, you know, like I was saying on Twitter, let me go to Twitter, what I was saying. I also said this in today's video, but 9 out of the last 11 bull runs or end of bull runs, or I should say 9 out of the last 11 years in Bitcoin's trading history ended with an end of year rally, you know, right alongside the stock market. And stock market's bullish right now, Bitcoin's bullish right now, and we're just kind of, you know, moving into a classic end of bull run scenario, going right into the end of the year, right into the new year. This is so classic for Bitcoin, and it's actually kind of mind-blowing that everything is just going as we expected. Like, it's right? Like, so a lot of times you think, I can't possibly just do what we want, but it's Bitcoin has kind of just done exactly that. I mean, the prophecy is being fulfilled. It's pretty incredible. Absolutely incredible. So at this point, you know, you could just start, you know, pulling up your Fib extensions, trying to see where you're going to be looking to target. Right. So let's go to Bitcoin. Look at the Fibs here. You know, for me personally, I think that the first target is the 1618 to 87,000. The Fib is not perfect. It's about 87,500. And that is the first medium term upside target. So we could probably get to 87.5. Much, much faster than people expect. Usually it's always how it is, right? Bitcoin always, you know, does things faster than you think it will. So 87,500 is likely to be, you know, coming in the short to medium term. And then after we hit that target, I think we might see a major shakeout and a retrace right back to 65, followed by a major explosive move into the six-figure level. Right. So this is very classic Bitcoin. So check this out. You know, and personally, guys, you know, I'm a long-term trader. I don't care about those little moves. I'm not going to sell there to buy back lower because it might not happen. I'm looking for much higher sell targets. And one thing I want to show you guys that we talked about in the Patreon voice chat just yesterday is that if you take your horizontal lines and you mark up, you know, the break, this is 2017, right? You have the breakout zone. And what's interesting is that, you know, when Bitcoin broke out above 3,000, just showing you guys the nature of the market, like how parabolic trends usually behave. When you get above the breakout zone, what did Bitcoin do? It literally returned straight back to the high. And a lot of people, you know, they sit there and they say, you know, if I was trading this in 2017, I would have just held. You know, I would have just held. No, you probably would have been pissing your pants as all the gains you just thought you had got reduced back to zero, right? Touch the previous high and then go to the moon. So these are the type of crazy volatile moves you kind of have to be ready for, right? So what I'm saying is it's possible that Bitcoin's going to rip up. I don't know, maybe we go to 87, maybe we go even higher, and then at some point retrace back to the previous high. I think it'll probably be more so 87,000 back to 65 and then up again, right? So you're gonna be, you know, it's gonna be an emotional time, I think, moving forward. This is usually just how things go from my experience. Just expect a lot of volatility, right? Though getting above this all-time high right now is fantastic. It's a really bullish sign. And it, you know, historically, you know, Bitcoin, you know, breaking above the previous all-time high in the middle of a bull market means massive hundreds of percent gains are coming. I mean, if you're just looking historically, that's usually what it means. Let me see what chat's saying. What's up, guys? We got 300 people watching. Definitely smash the like button. People are in the chat talking trash on bearish influencers right now. Yeah, guys. I'm not going to read this on live stream. Here, check out this tweet I made yesterday. Because I felt the all-time high coming. I said, I'm done being polite to bears. And I'm just going to trash every bear and every troll that comes my way from here on out. Because they've been so incredibly wrong. And I'm done listening to them, guys. I'm done listening to the bears. You know, maybe when we get above six figures, then we can start listening to the bears. But guys, I'm done. I'm fed up with the bears. Right? I'm just fed up with them. They've been so wrong. And now that is quite evident now. So that's cool. So I'm curious to see what's going to happen this week. Because this is a really, really good start to a new week, right? We pushed above the previous wick. An awesome start to the week. And remember, guys, remember this? Go back, going back to the 20K breakout. Hold on 1 second. The 20K breakout point right here, or I guess it was just below, about 19,000. And we launch above 20K. That was a 22.5% weekly move up. Guys, this candle right here, 22.5% in 1 week. Do you guys see what I'm talking about? Let me just zoom into 20K. That's 20K, right? 20,000, the break above 20K right there. This is December, end of 2020. Break above the all-time high, 22% in a week. So what's possible? What is possible right now for Bitcoin? I mean, yeah, we could totally see something like that again. I mean, we could end this week, guys. We could end this week at 75K. We could end this week at 75,000, guys. And that is less than 20% away. Or sorry, from the beginning of the weekly, I should say. Not from here, but... yeah, I mean, ending this weekly candle at 75,000, as crazy as that might sound, it's not really that crazy at all, actually. Guys, let me know where you guys think we're going to end this weekly candle. Let me know in the chat. Where do you think we're going to end this week? I say 75,000 by the end of the week. Quite possible. That is no different than that 20K move. Bang. These are, guys, you know, people always underestimate Bitcoin. They always say, oh, it can't happen, it can't happen. And then it just goes ballistic. Goes way faster than you think. And there's a lot of reasons why you could, you know, there's supporting evidence as to why this could be going much faster than we think. The long-term holder supply shock is at a position now where historically being up this high means you're at, you know, a low point in the trend. You know, and you're usually looking for basically major distribution from the whales. But as that distribution takes place, you know, you're going parabolic. You know, look at this. Look at 2017. Massive distribution from the long-term holders. Huge pump. The lower this goes, the more likely we're at the top, but usually we're going parabolic. So right now we're at peak, we're at the best place, right? This can go on for months into the first quarter of 2022. Massive pump into six-figure level. All very possible, all very likely. Bitcoin to liquid supply shock ratio, you know, bursting into new all-time highs. Supply shock is well in effect right now, guys. And, you know, the S&P seasonality chart, stock market's bullish right now. If the stock market's bullish, crypto does well. If the stock market's super bearish, crypto doesn't do well. So we have a good stock market right now. And this is the past 20 years of data. The S&P usually moons into the holiday season. And that supports the Bitcoin pumps going into the end of the year, new year, right? That's why Bitcoin, you know, kind of does that as well, historically. It's all correlated, guys. It really is all correlated. So I say by the end of this week, 75K is totally possible. Oh yeah, and also, I mean, not to mention, oh yeah, this is a great meme right here. Bitcoin's going to 200K and is not up for debate. We're holding the bears at gunpoint. It is not up for debate, guys. We're going to 200. Yeah, this post chain like coming for your favorite altcoins with CCIP. Let's see here. Trying to find the infamous three peaks in a domed house, which I talk about all the time. And I know it's probably repetitive, but guys, it's so important. It's so important. I mean, I made this call in June of this year, in June 20th, right? That was, I'm pretty sure I was the first channel on YouTube to call it. And then, you know, now we're finally playing this out, right? I called it down here. Now we're at the first floor. We're currently at the first floor, and we're actually exiting the first floor territory. We're now in between first floor and roof, guys. That's the exciting part. You know, according to this model, we're currently, you know, with the new Bitcoin all-time high break, we're in between first floor, now exiting first floor, heading to the roof. I mean, look at this, guys. Look at what gold did in 2011. Look at this. Pretty epic moves for gold. And I think Bitcoin's going to follow. Might happen faster for Bitcoin, actually. But yeah, guys, we're ready to go to the roof. What do you guys think? You guys think we're going to follow this model? I mean, so far, so good. It's perfect. It's absolutely perfect. Three peaks in a domed house has been, I mean, just like a dream to just be following as a model for this run. Just checking out chat real quick. What have I missed? So I asked you guys in the chat what you think the end of week price will be. We got a lot of people kind of agreeing with me. I said 75,000 by the end of the week. And people in chat are saying 70, 74, 72. Some trolls saying 10K, of course. Somebody who says, can you elaborate on your sell targets? I can. You know, a lot of people, you know what's interesting, guys? What I've noticed is that people have like post-traumatic stress disorder from the 2018 bear market, right? Or even just from this dump right here. And like, it's like every time we just like touch a new all-time high, like for any coin, they're like, do I sell now? Should I sell? And it's like they're trigger happy because they don't want to get hurt. But guys, that if you're being trigger happy about selling like right now because you don't want to get hurt because you think it's just a bull trap and it's over, I mean, you know, you're trading on emotion. You're trading on emotion, and you shouldn't be trading on emotion. I mean, you should be like a emotionless hodler until your targets are hit. In my opinion, not financial advice, of course. Oh yeah, one of my top alt picks recently, KuCoin KCS, is ripping into new all-time highs. About to touch $24. That's awesome for everybody in Patreon that got in early. In Patreon, we were buying this, you know, in between like, I mean, anywhere from like $7 to $15, to be honest. We were buying it all over the place. This was a huge range. I mean, I was being really patient with this one. Took so long to get here. But now, KuCoin KCS, guys, KuCoin token, I believe this is going to be a top 25 coin. Top 25. Let's check it out. Let's pull up CoinGecko. KuCoin, number 93. I'm saying my prediction for KuCoin is that it's going to be a top 25 coin. And the reason is because it is basically in a similar position as Binance early on. I don't think it'll necessarily be as big, but even if it's somewhat as big, it'll do really well. And I think, and also, of course, they have the KCC chain, the KuCoin community chain. KCS will be used as gas. They have regular token burns. Right, a lot of great stuff going for this one. And now we're touching, you know, $24. And I'm telling you guys, you know, of course, nobody knows, but I do think it's going to be top 25. So, you know, I basically think that, you know, basically if you got in below $20, you're in before any of the real growth happens. Now we're above it. So now we're starting to see that growth finally come in. So congrats to all those that got into KuCoin. I think this is going to be hundreds in the next few months. So let's see. Somebody was asking about my targets. So when we're talking about targets, price targets, you can go with a couple different, you know, you have to also kind of ask yourself what's realistic. What is really realistic about this, about this run? How high can Bitcoin really go? You know, and where are you realistically going to take targets? And another thing is, people seem to just want to like sell everything all at once. They want to be like, I just want Bitcoin to hit 250K and I'm going to sell everything at that price. And that's dangerous because you might not make any gains at all. If you just wait for one price to show up, you might make nothing, right? Because guys, we all know how crypto works. Everything above 65 is a bubble. Everything above here, we will likely come back to in the bear market. We know how this works, right? Most people coming into this market new don't know that. They think that they're you know, getting in at a great time and it's just going to be up and, you know, off to the races forever. Guys, we're going to come back to these levels most likely and probably lower, right? We know how this goes. We know how this game is played. Retail will be suckered in somewhere up here, right? And then they'll get dumped on and we'll come back to these levels or lower, right? This is just what's likely. This is just how Bitcoin traditionally behaves. I'm going to reevaluate the market at 124,000. At 124,000, I'm going to reevaluate the market. So that's my first sell target, is 124K at the 2618. I'm going to take 25% profits right here, 25%, right? And then reevaluate. Do I need to take more profits here? Or do I let the rest ride and it's looking good, right? And it depends, you know, anywhere from 180 to 124 is a big zone for me. Right below 200K is a big reevaluation zone for me to see how realistic is it that we're really going to get above 200, right? And I'm going to reevaluate things there. Do I need to, you know, we'll see. Maybe we do go higher, right? We'll see. And a lot of that has to do with the guys, the on-chain metrics. You know, the on-chain metrics are so important. And if you guys are like in the Patreon, you guys have heard me talk about this probably 1,000 times, but I mean, it's important. You know, we're looking at like the PL multiple, the profitability of miners. The biggest bears in the market, guys, the biggest bears in crypto are miners, right? So the PL multiple shows the profitability of miners, all right? You know, this is 2017. You know, when the miners are sitting on excessive profits, you know, we come back to an average, you know, a fair valuation. Same thing happened here in 2013. When we get excessive profits for miners, we come back to a fair value, right? We're not going to live in fantasy land here, guys. When this thing pumps up, we're going to come back to a fair value. You know, we're going to come back below where we are now. So you gotta be prepared for this. And also, you know, basically the PL multiple, check this out. Historically, when the PL multiple gets here to a, you know, this is 2013 when Bitcoin was a low cap, 2013, when you're hitting a five, I mean, you're at the top, right? Okay. So then over here, 2018, when you're touching a five, it's the top. Now, 2019, you're touching a 2.5. And again here, 2.5, that was a top, not a cycle top. So, but if the PL multiple pops up here to a five, it doesn't matter what the price of Bitcoin is. It doesn't matter. If the PL multiple is sitting at a five, it doesn't matter what the price is. That is going to be a likely top, right? So you got to look at the on-chain metrics. What else do we got? I mean, the Mayer multiple has been pretty reliable historically. Again, it doesn't matter what the price is, guys. When the Mayer multiple hits these levels, you know, a 3.25, a three, you know, if we're getting there, I mean, you gotta be, it doesn't matter what your ideal sell target is. You have to be just kind of taking what you got, you know, at that point. You're gonna be looking at these Mayer multiple, PL multiple, what else we got? There's a lot, I mean, there's a lot of other stuff too. Buying power chart is also very key, very, very good for predicting moves. Usually when buying power is sitting at a peak, you're in the middle of a run, right? You're like in the midst of a run, usually. Like even right here, we were like in the middle of this pump. So then you see it, you know, when you see this green potential buying power cross over into stablecoins actually being deployed, that's what the red means. You're starting the run on the crossover, and then you're ending the run on the crossover back down. But in the middle of the spike, you're in the middle of the run, right? And this was actually one of the things that helped me call the 30,000 bottom with such certainty. People were so angry at me for being so certain and confident that it was going to be the bottom. But I mean, check this out, stablecoin flow ratio. On this chart, the red means stablecoins are being deployed, right? And this crossover took place here, right there. While we were creating the bottom, it meant that, wow, look, support's coming into the market. So these are all these on-chain metrics, guys, that you gotta be, it's so important. And this is how I'm gonna judge the peak and the top and the price targets where I'm gonna sell. You know, a lot of people say like, I'm just gonna sell at that price. And it's like, yeah, I mean, I don't know. You gotta look at the on-chain metrics and it doesn't matter what the price is. Luke, who says coming in with the 5 euros. Hi, Kevin, can you have a look at Origin Trail chart, tell us what you think. I'm not gonna do anything too in-depth for any altcoins right now. I mean, today is definitely Bitcoin day, guys. You know, I don't wanna like dive into a bunch of alts necessarily. I mean, is it mooning or something? Like, Yeah, it's just mooning. I mean, this is like, what kind of analysis am I going to do on this? I would have to take a look for a much longer period of time, but you know, I'm not gonna give you an opinion on this if I haven't actually analyzed it. It's in the middle of a moonshot, so God bless it, right? Yeah, Loop Ring is mooning right now, and sadly, I sold it, guys, months ago. But though I originally bought this at like 16 cents, made the Patreon call for it, and now I'm a sad boy. I'm a really sad boy now. But sometimes it's how it goes, right? But I do have KuCoin. That's number third top performer today. So KuCoin making up that Loop Ring terrible sell that I made. Crypto.com's been doing well recently as well. People are saying, listen to Plan B. I mean, of course, guys, I think we've all looked at Plan B. I mean, I don't know, guys. Someone says Plan B has been more accurate than you. I mean, yes, true, absolutely true. But I don't know. Since that 30K dump, I think I might have nailed it a little bit closer than him here. This was like, I mean, like a godsend model. But other than that, yes, of course. Plan B is top notch. What do we got here for stock floats pulled up? It's looking really good. I mean, it's really, you know, we had our first flat top in Bitcoin history. I don't know if you guys know that. The 65K peak was the first flat top in Bitcoin history. And we had a lot of sideways, and you know, then we dumped, had a lot of sideways, you know, Wyckoff distribution, accumulation. So we're a little bit behind the 2017 schedule, but it's pretty damn close, guys. It's pretty damn close. Check this out. I always look at this because it's really cool. Look at this. The purple is now, the yellow or the orange is 2017. I mean, look how close we are. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. We're like right on track. Bitcoin hasn't even updated today, but we're probably going to pump it right alongside the 2017 timing. I mean, in terms of the performance since the last market cycle top, from here, from, you know, the first bull market to the second bull market, 2021 and 2017 are the closest in performance ever. So I don't know, lengthening cycles, yeah, maybe by a hair, but not really all that significant this time because of the money printing and stuff. Thoughts on Ethereum? I mean, yeah, we already hit all-time highs for Ethereum. It's looking good. People are asking for a Patreon discount. I mean, maybe I'll do like a holiday thing or something. Just looking at chat right now. Yeah, so we're ready for a moonshot, guys. It's quite clear. Everyone, this is so disappointing. Everyone in the chat is saying, oh my God, I'm making so much money from LRC Loop Ring. Because I recommended it for like the better part of a year. And then I was like, oh, I'm going to buy something else. And I sold it. And it's just terrible. Terrible. I'm sad. But good for you guys. Glad you're making money on the call. Someone says Matic is dead. Why would you believe that? Why? What makes you say that? You guys are too funny, man. It's like if a coin doesn't move for like 12 hours, people think it's dead. Or they're like, I'm not satisfied. It hasn't moved in 12 hours. Man, people treat crypto like a slot machine. I mean, oh yeah. Yeah, tell me. Yeah, look how dead Matic is. Look at it. Check it out, guys. Look how dead this is. We're literally about to hit a new all-time high. I don't know what's dead about this. We're ready to go, guys. Matic is ready to go. Sometimes, you know, Polygon has more users than Ethereum Layer 1. So I have no doubts that we're going to see massive, massive gains here. Let's pull up Ethereum. People are saying it's popping off. Matic looks great. Also, I love to brag about the 4 cent call in Patreon. 6,000% gains for patrons that took the call then. Where? Let's see. Yeah, Ethereum's chart is just the best chart. It's just literally the best chart in crypto. It's like the head, it just had like, it's just like the stairway to heaven, a perfect macro upper sloping trend line. Look at this. Could you call these three white soldiers or four white soldiers or something like that? I'm not totally familiar with it, but I could totally see us get a major pump. You know, if Bitcoin does do what I think it's going to do, and if Bitcoin does sort of do what it did at 20K with a 22% weekly pump after it broke with the all-time high of 20K, you know, we get like another 20% up and land at 75. I mean, Ethereum could see some pretty epic moves. I mean, Ethereum, let's see, what would that be for Ethereum? I mean, that's like 5,500 at the end of the week. $75,000 Bitcoin at the end of the week, $5,500 Ethereum at the end of the week. This is just a total guess, guys. You know, I mean, I do think it's possible, though. Don't bank on it. It's not financial advice either. Oh, my bad, guys. Am I knocking on something? I do have a restless leg. I'm so sorry about that. I think I'm just too excited. My leg is just like bouncing around. Is thoughts on Elon's stock? So I mean, I don't even own. I don't own Tesla, guys. Is it dumping? Did everyone dump it? No, it's doing pretty good. I mean, I guess it's down the past few hours. Or I mean, in the previous session. I mean, we'll see. I mean, don't you guys think that Tesla's completely overvalued? I mean, am I the only one that thinks that these days? Didn't Michael Burry from the movie The Big Short took a short position, and I guess now he's out. You know, the same thing happened to Michael Burry in the housing collapse when he shorted, and the market went against him, and everyone thought he was going to be wrong. And then, you know, at the last minute, he was right. So is history going to repeat itself? Michael Burry is going to be calling the shots too early. Everyone thinks he's wrong, and then he's eventually right. I haven't followed what he said about that. Yeah, I mean, people, you know, you guys, I see so many like questions in the chat about, you know, this altcoin, that altcoin, my thoughts. Guys, this is what we call everything season. Everything season is a real thing where everything goes up. All right, look at 2017. Everything season. Like you had short periods of like Bitcoin dumps, gains dominance again. But, you know, this entire time that Bitcoin dominance was collapsing throughout all of 2017, you know, Bitcoin's still mooning. It's still mooning the whole time, and so is everything else. So, you know, we're very likely about to enter what's called everything season. And it's kind of been a little bit like that recently, but we'll see. We're getting a lot of sideways here. But I do think that Bitcoin dominance is likely to head down to an all-time low. Because as crypto becomes, you know, bigger and bigger, Bitcoin is going to have less dominance over time. Just guaranteed to take place. Like the industry is just going to get massive over time, and Bitcoin is going to lose a lot of dominance. So you could expect each cycle, like Bitcoin just going to new all-time lows, you know, next bull market, new all-time lows again for dominance. That's what I think. So yeah, everything's season, guys. As long as the altcoins you own aren't terrible, they're probably going to pump to some degree. Everything season is upon us. But yeah, guys, I think it's possible that Bitcoin hits 75,000 by the end of the week. Maybe. I could be wrong. And then Ethereum would hit like 5,000 to 5,500 by the end of the week. Again, this is just based off of, you know, what Bitcoin did when it broke 20,000. And, you know, also, I mean, what, you know, kind of, this is very common here as well. You know, 2017, what did we do when we broke the all-time high in 2017? I mean, massive weekly gains each time. This is just the speculative nature of crypto, and this is the emotional feedback loop. You know, everybody that buys in gets excited. It's just the crowd gets bigger, the crowd gets louder as you move up. And we're literally on the precipice of a massive parabolic shift here into a six-figure Bitcoin. But once again, guys, we will likely come back in the bear market. But guys, that's it for this live stream. Just wanted to hop on here while Bitcoin was mooning and hitting new all-time highs, talk to you guys a little bit. Because I know you guys definitely love those all-time high live streams. But definitely smash the like button on your way out. Subscribe. You know, follow me on Twitter, join the Discord, join the Patreon. Also, sign up for Cryptowatch using that link below. There's also a new Cryptowatch mobile app on the App Store. You can type it in, find it there. And guys, that's it. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you soon.
Hellraising. Hellraising. I'm ready for the worst. So frightening. Face whitening. Fear that you can reverse. My phone has no signal. It's making my skin crawl. The silence is so loud. The lights spark and flicker with monsters much bigger than I can control now. Welcome to the panic room, where all your darkest fears are gonna come for you, come for you. Welcome to the panic room, you'll know I wasn't joking when you see them too, see them too. Welcome to the panic room. To begin, there's no crying wolves now, 'cause
truth, I said, oh, this.